Hey there, typewriter people. This is Joe with Ink and Iron, and I actually have the results of my SM7 typewriter cleaning. This is actually my second day with the machine. I spent yesterday, because I got it yesterday, I spent it cleaning the machine itself, and then today after work, I took the case and managed to really give it the attention that it required. So let's get to it. I'll show you the case first. Okay, so here we are looking at my lovely brown carpet. And look at this case. That big brown stain on it is gone. This handle looks way better. Couldn't get this pink off. Still a little bit of stuff right there, but in the process of cleaning, I may have scratched the chrome a bit, but I don't really care. Oops. This lock still isn't amazing. Yeah. So looks a bit grungy on the inside, I know, but there was not much to do about that. What do I want to show you? These hinges. So, this is hard to do working around the camera. There we go. Okay. So, bottom hinges. Still a bit rusty, but pretty solid. This one moves a bit. I think the rest of them are basically stable. I had to rehammer these rivets. I was able to keep the same rivets, which was nice. This is looking a little less rusty. Definitely much more solid. The case goes together a lot more solidly. The only thing that happened, because I was handling this so roughly, look at this. See this crack? Yeah, the outside pieces, like you can tell, these are two separate pieces joined by probably a lip on the inside, and then like glued or something, and then covered over on the inside so you can't tell. But yeah, there's, if I move the top away from the middle, it starts to split. So that's a problem for another day. But let's get on to the typewriter itself, because I am very excited to show you that. All right, we are back, and for, you know, dramatic effect, I have draped the typewriter in this cloth. Let's check it out. So this thing is looking awesome, and I am going to take the camera, well, my phone, off of the tripod so I can give you a closer look. But this thing is sparkling clean. And really, its only flaw is that it's missing its logo right here. I may just slap something on there in the future, you know, just for fun. But if I do that, I will update you. Now, let's get a closer look. I planned ahead this time, and off camera, loosened the ribbon cover. So I didn't put any more insulation in there yet. It's not a huge issue at the moment. Oops, let me set this aside somewhere. Okay. Look how clean these type bars are. I have not actually used them with this ribbon yet. Like, I just put it in. If you're really keen, you can probably tell that these are Royal Vintage spools. I actually grabbed this ribbon out of my Royal Mercury while I wait for a replacement, because I really like having black and red. Yeah, let's get in here. Sorry about that. Got a phone call in the middle of recording. Anyway, the card guide had some whiteout trapped back in here, and I was able to get that out. And I'll actually post a little video of its own with the tip on how to get that out of there without disassembling all of this nonsense, because that was my goal. shined up this. I mean, these type bars look spotless. Took a lot of time getting off gunk that had just built up over the years. You know how it goes. The key tops, they were always in good shape. I didn't really have to do anything with those, which was nice. I adjusted all these anchor points for the ribbon cover because it was rattling and I was not enjoying it. What else? Had to clean the platen because there were just a bunch of little bits of whiteout rolling along it. There's still a little bit, but not nearly as much. It looked like it was, you know, snowing. What else? Just kind of cleaned these. Stay in focus. Cleaned these paper bale rollers. They're super smooth. Yeah, so I didn't have to work that hard. Let's unlock all this. I think, are we good? Okay. Focus. Oops, wrong way. Still figuring out how to do this one-handed. So the bell works. And let me lean in. There's no gritty sound anymore. Just sounds like a clean mechanism. So, yeah, it was just dirty, I would say. What else? What else did I do? Not a whole lot. Blew some air through here, so come on. Focus. There is not a whole lot of stuff underneath in the guts of this machine. There's a little back there. Couldn't reach it with my little dusting paintbrush or even the compressed air. Couldn't really get it off. It's that old whiteout. It has a tendency to stick pretty securely for some reason. Even all these years later. Let's tip it back. So you saw the bottom already. It's clean. By the way, serial number 1999715. There we go, now you can see it. Yeah, the bottom was easy. I just kinda brushed it off and shot some compressed air at it, and that was about it. So, let's do a typing test and finally see what this font looks like. This is a half inch silk ribbon, so the impression should be super, super nice. Sorry for the shakiness of this video. Part of the time, the tripod is actually on my desk chair, which is wheeled. So it shakes around whenever I pull the mic cord or, you know, jostle stuff around. And let's not forget my favorite feature. Ba-boom. Nice paper rest. Okay. So we have this triple space. Get past our writing from yesterday. Single. You know, the shift is a bit heavy. Maybe I could adjust that later, but that is a minor complaint of mine right now. Oop, I'm on red setting. Good to know that's working. Okay, coming off the tripod. Look at that. Very nice, clean impressions. Let's see, our K. K is much cleaner than it was yesterday, and I know the ribbon was awful. G is also clean. It means I got in all of the little holes, like the circle of the O and the G of the D. You know, I got in all those little crevices that like to hold ink particles and such. So, yeah, everything is working as it should. I am really stoked to continue, start using this machine frequently. A little scuffing, nothing too crazy. Yeah, so if you like this video, feel free to subscribe, like, and comment on my content. I'm always looking for new ideas. I do knife and fountain pen videos as well. You know what? Oh, look at that. I've got some right here. It's the Spyderco Caribbean Salt and an awesome pen, which actually you haven't seen on YouTube yet, so let me put that to the side. Literally no one's reviewed that. But yeah, this is not my only typewriter, so if you want to see more content, want to know what my cleaning methods are, etc., like I said, drop me a comment, interact, and I will be available. Alright, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next video. Ah, the magic of editing.